Hey Al, Mike Stryker here. How's it going? I have been a longtime fan of yours. I have all your albums on vinyl, tapes, CDs, DVDs, Laserdiscs, VHS, you name it, I pretty much have it. I've seen you live in concert every time you've come to Winnipeg, and I can't wait to see you again in Milo's Murphy's Law and the new season of Comedy Bang Bang. After reading The Authorized Al and Weird Al the Book, I found a book on Amazon that I didn't yet have. There wasn't much I didn't know about you already being a superfan, but I decided to give it a crack anyway. Little did I know that I was about to be treated to this. I normally don't read reviews since I always fear spoilers, so I decided to buy this blind. As soon as I got it though, I knew I was ripped off. The purpose of this video is to let you know what kind of things this author is writing about you. I know if I had a book written about me, I'd want to make sure it was at least accurate. Let's start off with the front cover itself. The picture's incredibly pixelated, as it looks like it was taken directly off a Google Images search. It's also been skewed, and I'm pretty sure you weren't fat yet. In fact, this exact image happens to be one of the photos you sold during your Alcan tour. So this guy's ripping off your copyright as well. Look at this! Look at this! Really? It's quadruple spaced! The whole book is like this! Oh, and check it. No page numbers. Guess he didn't want you to know how short it really was. There's a free gift offer! Let's click to claim our prize. Nothing. Still nothing. Guess I'll have to get my prize another time. Let's skip to the back of the book now, shall we? What's this? An advertisement for Mike Tyson? The author's next book? Why would I care about Mike Tyson in a Weird Al book? I would play this if I wanted to know more. Let's keep going. More links! More clickable links for the author's books! A good fifth of this book has nothing to do with you! Starting to get the sense you're getting ripped off? Unfortunately, it gets worse. He spells your nickname in so many different ways and capitalizations that it makes me want to cry a bit inside. He completely butchers your last name. He spells the lead singer of Nirvana's name incorrectly. He doesn't understand the purpose of apostrophes. He has troubles differentiating between form and from, which is strange because sometimes he gets it right. Needs to know the difference between two, and two. Proper capitalization is a must if you're going to be referencing album or song titles. As a programmer, I didn't think you could recode, Al. We should probably talk soon. And he tries to put quotes around blurred lines, but uses two different quote types, one being a double quote and the other being a single quote. I found that incredibly funny, considering that your parody of blurred lines happens to be all about grammatical mistakes. Makes me wonder if he even listened to any of your songs. Now that that's out of the way, here comes the more cringeworthy stuff. This will make anyone who knows you even just a little bit go, "Huh?" While it is true you come up with your own ideas for song parodies, there was this one case with Madonna where word got to you from her saying she wondered when you were going to do a parody of hers. According to this author, though, it sounded like a personal request from her, directly to you. Now, I know I wasn't there, but I'm pretty sure that's not how it went down. The author flat out claims that Madonna was in your Like a Surgeon video. Everybody knows that that wasn't her, but she was an amazing local lookalike contest winner. Due to the poor performance of Polka Party, the author thinks you shied away from the accordion entirely for your Even Worse album. But wait, what's this? Doth my ears deceive me? Is this not lasagna? And is there an accordion playing? This guy didn't even try. The track Twister, as you know, is a stylized parody of the Beastie Boys' music. Don't let the author know that. He thinks it was a direct parody. My challenge to him would be, which song? He states the song Fat is only about how much junk food you eat. I'm starting to see a pattern here if he even listens to your music. He hasn't even watched any of your videos. He says that the video Fat shows you mowing down all kinds of fatty foods. The only thing you ever ate out of that whole video was a ham on whole wheat, which is pretty healthy considering. I didn't know your seventh album was called Smells Like Nirvana. I thought it was called Off the Deep End. Did I miss something? Speaking of which, Nirvana's album was called Smells Like Teen Spirit. Wait, never mind. I love the fact that your Smells Like Nirvana song was about how you couldn't understand what Kurt was singing about. But I don't think the author understands English, because he says your whole song was mostly gibberish. I'm pretty sure Bargle Nardle Zaus was the only confusing part. Guess words really do hurt for him. Okay, wait. What? Jurassic Park? Bedrock Anthem? Achy Breaky Song? These weren't hits? Whatever you say, buddy. Your song Saga Begins is about all the Star Wars movies. Now that can't be right, can it? I'm pretty sure it was only about The Phantom Menace. Not Attack of the Clones, not Revenge of the Sith, not A New Hope, not Empire Strikes Back, not Return of the Jedi, and not The Force Awakens. Yes, I realize the Saga Begins came out in 1999, but if he's claiming that it's about all the Star Wars movies, then it must be about all the Star Wars movies, even those who haven't come out. Apparently, It's All About the Pentiums is about time and watches. Where did he even get that information from? And what's even funnier is that he tries to make an ironic joke that the song was approved permission at the very last minute to do the song. No, buddy. The irony isn't there. I'm pretty sure it's elsewhere. Oh, man. I don't know where to begin on this one. I have to do a direct quote here for Straight Outta Linwood. It is clear from the cover and title of the album that there was a heavy emphasis on hip-hop and rap music for this project. You and I both know he's dead wrong for this one. Your Pitiful was supposed to be the lead track for Linwood, but it was a happy coincidence for White Nerdy to appear as the frontrunner. Come on, dude. Get your facts straight. Out of Linwood. Okay, first off, your dual-layer disc for Linwood was phenomenal. Loved hearing it in 5.1 surround sound. Please, 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 please do that again. He states that there was an extra disc with Linwood that you needed a computer to access the content. Sorry, no. Poodle Hat had extra content on it. Heck, even Running with Scissors had a small clip. No. I think he's getting confused with the Canadian version. For us Canucks, we didn't get a dual-layer disc. Instead, we got two discs. One DVD, one CD. Without the 5.1 surround sound. I imported mine. Oh, did I forget to mention that your 12th album was also called White and Nerdy? Didn't know that either. So your Apocalypse DVD contained all the videos, eh? I don't think so. The DVD contained most of the videos, but it was the Blu-ray that contained all of them, with White and Nerdy, Do I Creep You Out, and Trapped in the Drive-Thru. And the creme de la creme! Did you know you actually went through with your Make It So parody of Let It Go on Mandatory Fun, and that it was a hit with the little kids? Let me see that track list for a minute. No, not on there. What about the CD? Bummer. I was hoping so badly for this book to be a parody, or a spoof, or even a troll to the fans. But the more I read, the more I felt he was actually being serious. I hope you're informed about this book, and I hope you other watchers out there take note. Read reviews. Don't waste your money. Be smart. Stay away from this book. Anyway, I gotta go prepare for your Winnipeg stop in August. Can't wait to see you again. Dying to hear Make It So.